Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another analytic geometry problem. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to derive the equation of the set of all points P of xy. Remember that P of xy is going to be a circle. If P, the center of the circle, is 3 times as far from the point negative 3, 2 as it is from the point 5, 10. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and draw out a graph quickly here of what we're looking at, just to give us a visual. So the point negative 3, 2 we'll call the point A, and that's going to be right about here. Again, this is a rough sketch. We just want to get a visual. Then we have the point 5, 10, which we'll call point B, and maybe that's right about here, something like that. So we have point A and point B. And then we have the center of the circle, P of xy, and maybe that point is something like right around here. Again, I don't know where it is, but we just want to get a visual of where it might be so that it's easier to wrap our heads around this. So we know that the point P is 3 times as far away from A as it is from B. So we can imagine this is a distance or a length of 1 and then 3 lengths, 1, 2, and 3, you know, approximately. So this point P is 3 times as far away from A as it is from B. So now what we want to do is find an equation that models the relationship between the distance A to P and the distance B to P. So we'll write the distances like this. This is the distance from A to P, and this is the distance from B to P. Well, we know that the distance between A and P is 3 times as large as the distance between B and P, which means that if we're going to set them equal to each other, we need to multiply the distance between B and P by 3 in order for these, for the two sides of this equation to be equal to one another. So we have this equation, and now what we want to do is go ahead and square both sides. Remember that we're working toward the equation of a circle, which is going to be the equation that models P of xy, the set of all points that is 3 times as far away from A as they are from B. So we're going to square both sides, and then we're going to use the distance formula over here, the distance formula, to plug in for the distance between A and P and the distance between B and P. So for the distance between A and P, we've got this distance formula here for the square root. We'll have x minus the x coordinate in point A, which is going to be negative 3. Since we have x minus a negative 3, that's going to be x plus 3 squared, plus y minus the y coordinate in point A, which is going to be 2. So we have y minus 2 squared. And that's going to be the distance from A to P, and then we've still got both sides squared, so this squared exponent comes down here. So now, over on the right-hand side of our equation, we've got this, we've got the 3 and the distance between B and P both squared. So let's go ahead and square the 3 and we'll get 9. And then we'll have the distance formula between that represents the distance between B and P squared. So again, just like the distance between A and P, we'll have x minus the x coordinate in B, which we know to be 5. So x minus 5 squared plus y minus the y coordinate in B, which is 10. So y minus 10 squared. We're going to take the square root of that. And then this exponent here is going to come down here, and this whole thing is going to be squared. So now that we have this relationship set up, it's just a matter really of finding the equation of the circle P of xy. So since both sides are the square of square roots, the squares are going to cancel with the square roots, and we'll just be left with what's inside. So over here, we're going to have x plus 3 squared plus y minus 2 squared. And then over here, we're going to have 9 times x minus 5 squared plus y minus 10 squared. So now we want to go ahead and multiply everything out on both sides, because we're going to try to combine all of our variables and constants onto one side and set this equal to 0 if we can. So over here on the left, we'll have x squared plus 6x plus 9 plus y squared minus 4y plus 4. And then over here on the right, we'll end up with 9 times x squared minus 10x plus 25 plus y squared minus 20y plus 100. Okay, so now we can go ahead and combine things on the left-hand side, and we'll multiply the 9 through the right-hand side. So over here on the left, we'll end up with x squared plus y squared, let's order our terms, plus 6x minus 4y, and then we have plus 9 and plus 4, which is going to give us a plus 13. And then over here, we'll order our terms in the same way and distribute the 9. So we'll get 9x squared plus 9y squared, takes care of these two, minus 90x, takes care of that, minus 180y, and then we have plus 125. 125 times 9 is 1,125, so plus 1,125. Now we want to go ahead and move everything over to the right-hand side so that we can get 0 on the left-hand side. So keep in mind that we're working toward the equation of a circle, which I've listed up here, and we'll see that start to come together as we move all the terms to the same side. So if we subtract x squared from both sides to move this x squared term from the left to the right, we'll end up with 8x squared on the left plus 8y squared when we subtract the y squared term. Negative 90x minus 6x gives us a negative 96x. Negative 180y plus 4y gives us a negative 176y. And then positive 1125 minus 13 gives us a positive 1,112 on the right. Now we want to go ahead and divide through by 8 because we can evenly, and that'll just simplify things a little bit for us. We'll end up with x squared plus y squared minus 12x, this is going to be minus 22y, and then plus 139. So that simplifies things for us just a little bit. Now we need to complete the square with respect to both variables on the right-hand side, because for the equation of a circle, up here we have x minus x sub 1 squared and y minus y sub 1 squared, and in order to get to that form, we need to complete the square with respect to both variables. So we'll group our x terms together. We'll get x squared minus 12x, and I'm going to leave a blank space there. Then we'll get plus y squared minus 22y, leave a blank space, and then we have plus 139 out here. So in order to complete the square, remember that you need to ensure that the coefficients on the quadratic terms are equal to 1. So we've got 1x squared here and 1y squared, so that part's done, we don't have to worry about it. Now we take the coefficient on the first degree term, so in case of x, that's negative 12, and we want to do negative 12 divided by 2 gives us a negative 6, and then we want to square that and we get 36, so we're going to add 36 in here. Then for the y squared term, or for the y variables, we'll take the negative 22, the coefficient on the first degree term, negative 22, divide that by 2, that gives us negative 11, then we want to take our answer and square it and get a positive 121. So we add 121 to the y variables. So 121 plus 36 is 157. So if we subtract 139 from that, we'll get, and I don't have my calculator in front of me, so 17 minus 9 gives us an 8, 1, so we'll get 18. So we have essentially allocated all of this 139 except 18. So if we that means we have to add, since we added 36 and 121 to the right hand side, we also have to add 36 and 121 to the left hand side. And we can now subtract 139 from both sides to move this over here. So negative 139. And what that does is, of course, leaves us with 18 over on the left-hand side, which we already found out. So let's go ahead and rewrite this cleaner so we can see it. We'll end up with 18 over here on the left. And then if we factor the right-hand side, if we factor x squared minus 12x plus 36, since we completed the square, we already know that we're going to get x minus 6 squared. For the set of y terms, we'll get y minus 11 squared. And now you can see this is in the exact same form as the equation of a circle. We have the x squared term, x minus 6 squared, the y minus 11 squared term, these two here, and then we have a constant over on the other side, which is going to be the radius squared. So what this tells us is that the center of our circle is at the point 6, 11, which we get from these two points here, 6 and 11. So the center of our circle is maybe about right here, as it turns out. And the radius is going to be the square root of 18, that left-hand side right there. So the square root of 18 will be 3 times the square root of 2. And whatever that turns out to be, you know, something like this, but basically P of xy is the set of all points that make up this circle, and all of the points along this circle end up being 3 times as far away from A as they are from B. So that's it. We would give this here, this equation, as our final answer, because this is the equation that constitutes the set of all points P of xy that meet this criteria. So that's it. That's your final answer. I hope this video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.